Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to one more episode on plant pathology. And in this video, let us focus on a plant disease called tomato leaf curl disease caused by tomato leaf curl virus. This virus belongs to a group of viruses which cause range of destructive plant diseases in worldwide. And these viruses are constantly evolving and threaten both agriculture and horticulture. There are two viruses. One is tomato leaf curl virus. The other one is tomato yellow leaf curl virus. These two are actually causing a lot of damage to tomato crop worldwide. Tomato leaf curl virus belongs to Bogomo virus family of the family Geminiviridae, and it has got a single stranded circular DNA as the genome, which is about 2.8 kb, and it is encapsulated within a twinned icosahedral viron or viral particle. So it's a protein coat which is icosahedral, and within which about 2.8 kb of DNA genome is present, and that is single stranded DNA, that is the genome of this virus. So this is what is the virus called TLCV, belonging to the family Geminiviridae. The host plant is tomato, which is Lycopus sicon esculentum, and tomato is a very important vegetable crop grown worldwide and also consumed worldwide. Coming to the symptoms, the plants show stunted or dwarfed growth. The leaves characteristically show rolled inward and rolled upward. That is the characteristic feature of this disease. Leaves are often bent downward and are stiff, thicker than normal, have a leathery texture, often have a purple tinge to the vein on the underside. Yellow leaves are slightly the young leaves especially are yellowish in color. The young leaves show slightly yellowish color. They become chlorotic. Flowers normally appear. They are very normal. Flowers don't show any symptoms. And fruits, if at all formed, they are small and they are dry and they are unusable. And affected plants tend to be distributed randomly or in patches, rather than the entire crop is affected. So the main symptom of this disease is incurling and inrolling of the leaves, which are actually bent upwards, and they are becoming yellowish and they dry later. The entire plant will die later because of the loss of photosynthetic pigment and loss of the chlorophyll pigment, and because of that the plant will ultimately die and the crop is completely lost. So these are the symptoms of this disease, and you are seeing here the infected leaves, and you can see the upward inward movement of the leaves here. And you are seeing in the picture B where the infected leaf is showing incurred and enrolled structure. You can also see in the lower picture also the leaves are severely affected by this virus. And you are also seeing the fruits here affected, and the fruits are actually very small and they are unusable, unsellable, and they are dry and they cannot be eaten or cannot be consumed at all. The spread of the disease is actually not done by seed or soil. It is actually transmitted from plant to plant when the plants are handled by the human beings during horticultural process. So they stain the infected plants, some of which may be weed plants, some even in the weeds also they survive and they remain there. And once the crop plant, that is tomato crop, is actually is cultivated in a crop land, and they come from the weed plants onto the tomato and they cause the infection. There is one big transmitter of this disease is called silver leaf white fly. It's called Bemisia tabacai, and this is actually a horticultural pest, and this is actually spreading the virus from infected plant to the uninfected plant. This is how this disease is spreading from one plant to the other plant, and this is the insect Bemisia tabacai, a silver leaf white fly, and this is actually causing the spreading of this virus. coming to controlling this disease, any viral disease is very difficult to control because we cannot spray any antiviral chemicals onto the plants. And the best method is sanitation. If you see a plant that is infected, and take it out from that crop and then take it away, far away, and burn it. So sanitation is the best method. The next best method is to use disease resistant varieties, which are resistant against this virus. That also is a big problem because the viruses are also constantly evolving. The third method is to control this fly, which I just now mentioned, this fly, white fly. If you control the white fly population, that is actually spreading the disease, and the disease can be controlled. Thank you very much for watching this video. We'll meet again in the next video with one more topic. Thank you. Please share, like, and subscribe to my channel so that you will get alerts whenever I release a new video. Thank you very much.